Hi everyone, it's Vicky here, and today I'm making a mixed media canvas. So my canvas is 8x8 inches, and it's 1.5 inch deep, so it's quite deep. Now I'm going to use these two pattern papers, and I'm going to use these pattern papers to create my background. I'm going to use my scissors and cut out little pieces out of them. Now these pattern papers are by 13 Arts, they come from their His and Hers collection. And as always, you will find a full list of all the supplies that I'm using down below in the description area. Now, if you are not familiar with 13 Arts, you see that I am using their gel medium here. They are a Polish company with amazing products. They have an online shop where you can get all the products that you need for your mixed media art. So here I am doing one of my go-to techniques for backgrounds. I am sticking down all those little pieces that I have cut down. I am using gel medium to stick everything down, and at the end you will see that just because all these pieces overlap one another, I am going to end up having a beautiful texture. And once I finish with the front of my canvas, I am going to go ahead and do the sides as well, since they are so deep. This is going to give a nice and finished look to my canvas. And now that everything is nice and dry on my canvas, I'm going to apply some gesso. You see that 13 Arts gesso is really thick, so it is great for doing dry brushing. I am going to use a stiff brush and apply some gesso over my canvas. I want to tone down the design at the background just a little bit, so I'm not trying to cover up the design at all, I am just trying to make it fade out. So you can see how it's looking now. And you can see the difference when you look at the sides. Of course, I need to do the sides as well. Now that my gesso is dry, I'm going to add some texture with some modeling paste and stencil. And now for some fun, I'm going to apply with sprays my color. So I'm using two of my favorite colors of all time from 13 Arts. And you can see how I can instantly get this beautiful background. And I'm going to repeat the same process for the sides of the canvas. And to add even more texture on my canvas, I am adding some splashes. Again, I'm using the same sprays that I used for my background. So everything matches perfectly. And you can see how easy it is to make the splashes by using the straw from that spray bottle or by using a thin brush. So now I'm going to use my heat gun to speed up the drying process, and you can see the beautiful result. Now I'm going to use one of 13 Arts stencils that I really love. I think this is very versatile and you can use it again and again on your projects. And I'm going to apply some black embossing paste with my spatula. Now I'm going to leave this aside to dry, and I'm going to work on my focal points. So I'm going to use this chipboard set, and I'm going to pick up one of those clocks, as well as those words that say dreams come true. I'm going to poke out all those little pieces inside that clock, as well as the inside circle of the clock, which I'm not going to throw away. I will use it later on. And I am also going to use this pattern paper, which is actually a leftover from the back from the pattern paper that I used in the beginning for my background. I'm going to use a pencil and draw the circle that fits inside that clock. And I'm going to cut it out of this black paper that has the same design as my background. Now you will see that I will not end up having that black background inside my clock, but I really need that texture, which is the same as the background. You will see what I mean later on. So now I'm going to use this copper paint. It is also by 13 Arts, and I'm going to color my clock. This paint has a beautiful shimmer that you cannot see at the moment, but I will try to catch the light later on so that you can see how beautiful it looks. I'm also going to color all those letters with black gesso, I believe. You can use black acrylic paint, whatever you have on hand. And I'm also going to use 13 Arts black gesso, which is also thick, and I'm going to do some dry brushing over that clock so that it doesn't look so perfect. I like to mix colors a little bit. So I'm happy with how everything is looking at the moment. I'm going to add just a little bit of that copper paint over the letters so everything matches perfectly. And I'm going to use my Tombow Mono Glue at the back of all those pieces to prepare them so that I can start assembling my canvas. And this is where I am going to stick that piece of chipboard that I haven't thrown, which was originally inside that clock. And this is going to ensure that I have an added dimension when I stick the clock on top of my canvas. Now, of course, I love working on my art journals, but one thing that I love when I am working on a canvas is the ability to be as dimensional as I want. So I am going to add a lot of elements here to make it really dimensional, but I also like to have things sticking out of the canvas from the sides, just like I did with the clock. I think that it gives it even more character and makes the piece even more interesting. And here's another beautiful pattern paper from the same collection by 13 Arts that has beautiful feathers front and back, and I have used my scissors to cut out some of them. Now, to match the colors with the background, I am spraying lightly over those feathers with the gold, the old gold spray that I used for the background. And to help all those feathers pop out even more from the background, I'm going to add a little bit of black gesso on the edges. Now, since those feathers are made out of paper, you can manipulate them and make sure that you add some dimension on them. Again, just because I'm working on a canvas and not on an art journal, on a book that has everything to be flat, I am playing around with textures and dimensions here. And I also have this string, and you can see that I am applying a little bit of that copper paint all over it to match the colors of my canvas. And now finally it's time to assemble my focal point on top of my canvas, and I am going for a dream catcher here. I am going to stick down the strings and then the feathers at the end of the strings by adding some glue at the back, as well as some foam tape for added dimension. And now I'm going to make the center of the clock more interesting. So I am going to use this pattern paper. I am using one of those capuchon domes, and I'm going to choose one of the butterflies, use my pencil to draw around that dome, and then I'm going to use my scissors to cut out the butterfly so that it matches perfectly behind my dome. And I'm going to use my gel medium to stick them together. I think that this is a great way to create your own customized embellishments. And this is going to look a little bit milky in the beginning, but once the gel medium dries, it's going to be totally clear. So here is Ginger, who was really interested on my embellishments. And I'm also going to use this metal clock that comes from the same collection by 13 Arts, but I am going to use my own foam squares at the back, just because I want to add even more dimension. So I'm going to double up on foam squares. And this sits nicely on top of that dome. Another embellishment that I'm going to use is this tiny little bottle cap that I had for ages and never used. So I'm going to add some gel medium inside that bottle cap, and I'm going to add some micro beads. These are copper micro beads by Prima. And they are going to stick where the gel medium was. So the idea is to create a cluster at the center of that clock, which is going to give dimension and interest on my project. And with my brush and gel medium, I am going to touch some other parts of this clock so that I can apply some of those micro beads here and there. The micro beads that don't stick on gel medium will fall on my craft mat so that I can easily pick them up and put them back on my jar. And different textures on these kinds of projects are really a must, so I'm going to add even more texture by adding some of this glass glitter. This is chunky glitter in copper. And I'm also going to use some of those brads that have beautiful gems that match perfectly the color palette of my art journal. I don't need those legs, so I'm going to chop them off and then stick those gems on my project. And here is a closer look to see where those gems are. To finish off that cluster, I'm also going to add some of those flowers. I have these paper flowers in white, and I always buy them in white because I can then color them in any color I want to match my projects. Before I stick those flowers down, I'm first going to use this copper acrylic paint. It's the same paint I used for the clock, and I'm going to go over that background. I'm first applying a very thin layer, and I'm going to go over it with a thicker layer, which is going to help that butterfly and the whole cluster to pop even more. So it seems that it's very thick and you cannot see the design at the background, so I am going to go over it with my baby wipe and lightly dab it so I do see the background coming through, but at the same time I have the shine. And the cluster pops even more. So to finish it off, now it's time to color my flowers. And I am using the same two sprays. Some of the flowers are turquoise and gold, and some of the flowers are just gold. And I am going to stick them down by using my matte medium. And that was the project for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. Don't forget that you can find the full list of all the supplies that I used today down below in the description area, as well as on my blog. Here are some close-up photos of the project I made today. Thank you all for watching!